evening. You're watching 7 at 7, the only news bulletin where we curate the day's top 7 stories for our viewers. Before I take you through the headlines, I want to quickly get our viewers up to speed where at least numerically India stands with its fight against coronavirus. We're going to give out the numbers right here. And viewers, we have right now breached the 40 lakh mark. Our total positive cases in terms of positive import right now stands at 42,04,613. We've reported across the country till now 71,642 deaths. It's also been a day where we have reported the maximum import of positive cases across the country, 90,000 and over. Let's go across and break it down in terms of states where we stand. Maharashtra continues to be the state recording the highest number till date, where we have till now 9,07,212 positive cases in Maharashtra, reporting 26,604 deaths. Andhra Pradesh, 2 weeks ago, took over the state of Tamil Nadu and is now recording a total of 4,98,125 positive cases, just about a shade short of 5 lakhs. Till now, Andhra has recorded 4,417 deaths. Tamil Nadu is third, recording 4,63,480 positive cases and a death toll of 7,836. All of this data collated till just about 20 minutes ago right here on India Today. Trust India Today to keep you right on top of the situation, at least where numerically the numbers of COVID-19 are concerned. We're very keen on getting up to speed with the latest in the Riya Chakrabarty case. Well, it was day two of the NCB summon today. She was questioned again, but not arrested. So no arrest of Riya Chakrabarty. However, there are lots of twists and turns. And why do I say that there have been so many twists and turns is that Riya Chakrabarty has now indicted Sushant's sister. Riya has lodged a police complaint against Sushant's sister Priyanka Singh before the Mumbai police. Riya in the complaint says Sushant was diagnosed bipolar despite his sister Priyanka prescribing her own medicines without holding any medical degree. Not only her, in her complaint she also named Dr. Tarun Kumar of the RML, the Ram Manohar Lohia Hospital, alleging that he prescribed medicines under the Narcotics Act without any consultation and prescribed them electronically, which is deemed illegal in Telemedicine Act. I want to immediately correct right now to my colleague Divesh Singh. He's been tracking developments. Divesh, it's over to you. The Narcotics Bureau had called her for the second time day to day for questioning, but Riya Chakrabarty not arrested. Give us the latest update.
Yeah, Preeti, it was the second day of questioning, and Riya Chakrabarty was quizzed by Samir Vankhede, who's the zonal director. Mr. Jain, deputy director general of the NCB, was also present while this questioning was going on, while KPS Malhotra, the NCB officer from Delhi, who is in Mumbai to probe this case, also grilled Riya Chakrabarty for a few hours. She was confronted with a few people, few arrested, accused, but as of now, we are yet to get confirmation on the person she was confronted with. But it yet remains that she is to be confronted with other accused who've been arrested, which involves Deepesh Sawant, Samuel Miranda, both staffers working for Sushant Singh Rajput, and also Shovik Chakrabarty, who's the brother of Riya Chakrabarty. Meanwhile, NCB officials have now said that Riya Chakrabarty is cooperating with the investigation. That is a positive sign for Riya Chakrabarty, because if they could place her under arrest for non-cooperation, but they themselves, while briefing media personnel, they have said this, that Riya Chakrabarty is cooperating with the investigation. Their sources have claimed that they are yet to get any crucial evidence against Riya Chakrabarty. She has denied all allegations of procurement, consumption and transportation of banned narcotic substances.
All right, Divesh, appreciate you joining us. Thank you for that quick update. So she's going to be called tomorrow as well by the NCP. But where does it stand? Where does the case of the NCB stand? I want to quickly cut across to graphics, which will help you get a better understanding of the drug route decoded on why the NCB could arrest Riya Chakrabarty. But this has been the drug route. The primary drug peddler, Anuj Keshwani, gave drugs to Kaizan Ibrahim, the secondary drug peddler, who in turn provided drug to Sushant Singh Rajput's staff. Now, there are three members of the staff: Samuel Miranda, the ex-house manager, Deepesh Sawant, the house help, Neeraj, the cook. Both of these, Samuel Miranda and Deepesh, have been arrested by the NCP. Now, they both handed over the drugs and passed on to Riya and Shovik. Now, Shovik has also been arrested. Riya, was called in for questioning for two straight days, but right now still not arrested. She's going to be called in tomorrow. So this is what primarily the drug route looks like, but I want to now, you know, cut across to the other big twist in this case. Now, what's really happened is Riya Chakravarti has turned it around. She's now pointed a finger directly at Sushant Singh Rajput's sister, Priyanka. What has Riya Chakravarti actually said? Well, she says that Priyanka provided drugs to Sushant, prescribed drugs by a doctor at RML Hospital. Riya has now lodged a police complaint against Priyanka. Riya in the complaint says Sushant was diagnosed bipolar. However, Priyanka gave him prescribed medicines without holding any medical degree. Not only her. In this particular complaint, Dr. Tarun Kumar of RML alleging that he prescribed medicines under the Narcotics Act without any consultation and prescribed them electronically, which is deemed illegal in Telemedicine Act. So what we are getting to know is our producers are just telling us that as we speak, Riya has reached the Bandra police station. So Riya right now, as we speak, viewers, is at the Bandra police station. That is news just coming in. We've just tapped into our wires and she's registering the complaint at the Bandra police station. So that's the very latest. Now, the complaint that we're talking about is against Priyanka, is against the doctor from the RML hospital who prescribed this particular prescription on telemedicine without consulting Sushant Singh Rajput face to face. He gave this prescription while Sushant was in Mumbai. This doctor was in RML Hospital. More so that the doctor in question is a cardiologist. He's not even a psychiatrist. And these viewers are psychotropic drugs. Psychotropic drugs is what we are getting to know. More so, like I said, news coming in. Riya Chakravarti is right now at the Bandra police station where she is lodging a complaint against Priyanka Singh, the sister of Sushant Singh Rajput. She says very clearly, I left on the 8th of June. Sushant Singh Rajput was found dead on the 14th of June. On the 8th of June, there is documented evidence in terms of WhatsApp chats which suggests that Priyanka gave Sushant medicines which were prescribed to her. So was it these medicines where somewhere down the line altered the medical or the mental condition of Sushant Singh Rajput and he took the step which is of suicide, possibly one angle? Well, she blames now Priyanka Singh for it. I want to connect right now to my colleague Munish, who's right now in front of the Bandra police station where she's lodging a complaint. Munish, what more can you add to this?
Yeah, well, at this point of time, Riya Chakravarti is inside the Bandra police station and she will try to get this written complaint converted into an FIR against Priyanka Singh, the sister of late actor Sushant Singh Rajput and the doctor who allegedly prescribed the medicines to Sushant Singh Rajput on June 8. Now, the written complaint clearly talks about the June 8 prescription which was sent by Priyanka Singh to Sushant Singh Rajput, in which the written complaint claims that in spite Priyanka Singh spoke to the doctor on phone, and then these drugs which has to be prescribed only after seeing the patient physically, these were prescribed on over phone. So her complaint is against Priyanka Singh and the doctor who sent the prescription on WhatsApp, and it was later sent to late actor Sushant Singh Rajput. So at this point of time, she is still inside the police station, and we will have to wait and watch that whether Mumbai police lodges an FIR or not.
Munish, before I just let you go, one question very quickly before I let you go. This complaint, can it be turned into an FIR now?
Yeah, well, it is completely on Mumbai police because the section under which the complaint has, this written complaint has been given, it is also about forgery, it is also about cheating, but also NDP.
Right now, you know, Munish, we're running short of time, so I'll just sum it up and I'm just coming in. Is now it's on the discretion of the Mumbai police to actually turn this complaint lodged by Riya into an FIR. What would those charges be? We still don't know because the police hasn't taken that action. Want to shift focus to the other big development taking place in Mumbai itself. It is on Kangana Ranaut now facing off with the Shiv Sena. Huge, huge blowout expected on the 9th of September when Kangana Ranaut has now challenged the Shiv Sena, saying she's going to come and they can do what they can if they want to stop her. Kangana slated to land in Mumbai on 9th, will have the security of 11 police personnel. Mind you, she's been given Y-category security by the Home Ministry, which includes one or two commandos as well. The security outside her Manali residence has also been tightened, and now the actor claims that the BMC has forcefully taken her Mumbai office and it would be demolished tomorrow. Kangana alleges she received several death threats after her tweet comparing Mumbai to POK and then to Taliban. Congress Shiv Sena have slammed the move, says she's a pawn in the hands of the BJP. Meanwhile, Shiv Sena MP Sanjay Raut hit back at Kangana. Raut said some people were maligning Shiv Sena and the party has always been respectful to women. This as Kangana, in a fierce response to Raut, demanded an apology.
Anil bhaiya, aamcha kattar karyakarta, Shivasenecha kattar karyakarta. Anek jana itar prantatun Mumbai tetat, Maharashtra tetat. Roji roti kamavtat, naav kamavtat. Kai jana Maharashtra tarun mantat, kai jana manat nahit. Pan Anil bhaiya matra Rajasthan madun ithe aale. Pahile मुंबई मंचर आणि मग तिथेही मन रमेना म्हणून मग नगरला गेले.
All right, so this is how it's playing out right now in Maharashtra. Kangana versus the Shiv Sena. What comes to that? Well, we do know that there is going to be an all-out confrontation come the 9th of September when Kangana decides to return. Let's quickly shift focus. In the wake of the rising COVID cases, still today, India decided to open metros for 5 months. Due to the COVID lockdown, metros across the country were shut. The metro train services finally resumed in a staggered manner across the country. In Delhi, the first metro departed from Hooghly City Central Gurugram to Delhi University at 7 a.m. As part of phase one operation, Delhi metro services have resumed only on the yellow line and will operate in shifts from 7 to 11 and 4 to 8 p.m. On September 9th, blue and pink lines will start operating, and by September 12th, all Delhi metro lines will be made operational for the commuters. Now, let's take you through. I'm going to put out some graphics here, and let's take you through on what is the standard operating procedure where the Delhi metros are concerned. Because, mind you, they come under heavy criticism that at a time when COVID cases are rising, why is it that we've decided to throw open our doors where metro lines are concerned? Now, the Delhi Metro Rail Corporation has made arrangements keeping COVID pandemic in mind. Apart from earmarked gates, hands-free thermal screening, 1,000 additional officials have been deployed to assist commuters. The carrying capacity of trains has been reduced to 20%. So this is what it looks like in terms of the standard operating procedure where the metro line is concerned. All right, let's cut across and ourselves pay homage today to a fallen hero. The army today bid farewell to Special Frontier Force Commando Nirma Tenzing, who was killed in action in war zone Pangong So on August 30th. It did make a political statement as well, because you had Mr. Ram Madhav, who went in there for this ceremony. A clear message to China honoring a Tibetan fallen soldier. Take a look.
India bid farewell to its hero, a Tibetan warrior, Subedar Nirma Tenzin of the Special Frontier Force. Tenzin was killed in action on the south bank of the Pangong So on August the 30th. But not before helping the Indian forces capture the strategic Blacktop and Helmet Top and repelling a Chinese hostile action. Bharat Mata Ki! Bharat Mata Ki! Bharat Mata Ki! Vikas Regiment! With chants of Bharat Mata Ki Jai and Jai Tibet, hundreds of locals and the Tibetan community attended the warriors' last rites. The coffin was wrapped in both the tricolor and the Tibetan flag. Proud of their Tibetan and Indian identities, those attending the funeral hummed songs of Tibetan nationalism and also India's national anthem. Posters at the funeral site hailed the Jawan as a hero for not just Tibetans but all of India, and one who lived for the love of Tibet and died for the love of India. Many joined in the funeral procession on their motorcycles and vehicles, waving the tricolor and the Tibetan flag. Several others walked to the cremation site. Following the protocol for those killed in action, army troops neatly folded the two flags and handed them over to Tenzin's wife. The event perhaps marked the very first public funeral for a soldier of India's super secret Special Frontier Force, also called the Vikas Regiment.
We are celebrating, like, we are saying the goodbye to the soul who have been sacrificed for the nation, not only for Tibetans, but also for India. And it is a very proud moment for all of us, for saying goodbye to him, for what he has done for all of us. Like, he is the martyr for all Tibetan as well as India.
The Braveheart was given a guard of honor, and officials from the army and civil administration laid wreaths. The BJP's National General Secretary Ram Madhav was also in attendance. It was a moment of pride for several Tibetans settled in India.
It's a very significant moment for us to come together and to recognize his martyrdom is very important for all of us. Tibetans are volunteering for this force, right? It's not that India is forcing them to do, no. We are greatly doing this for India, and this is our responsibility. This is our second home, and we are, you know, doing anything to save our second home from this dirty PLA intrusion.
The army has not officially put out details of what led to Tenzin's death, but sources said he stepped on a landmine. The Indian Army's message to China amidst an all-out standoff is loud and clear. The country won't shy away from acknowledging its braves who helped tame the dragon.
He lived for Tibet, died for India. This slogan sums up the life of Tenzin Nima, who sacrificed his life recently. His sacrifice means a lot to the Tibetan community that has been continuing their struggle for years now. It also means a lot to all of India and also to the Indian Army that is taking on the Chinese belligerents at the borders for the last 4 months. With camera person Satya and Bakir Cho in Leh, Abhishek Bhalla for India Today.
Our tributes, there are a few things sadder than to hear the last post play at the funeral of a young fallen soldier. With that, I'm going to go into a quick break to stay with us. Up next, we're going to bust certain... All right, before we go into a quick break, I want to take you through and bust a certain claim masquerading to be a fact on social media, which is a claim which says Adani Group buys Indian Railways. It's now Adani Railways. Well, this is just a claim and it's false. The fact check on that, Indian Railways has neither changed its name nor sold its trains. With this quick fact check, we're going to go into a quick break. To stay with us, up next is To The Point. Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.